hang.
Oh, hello, Sheriff. Storm's made me a little bit nervous. I've been jumpy all night. And time's stage due. Along about midnight, but I reckon the storm will hold it up some.
And Middle Fork Bridge washed out. They'll have to wait here till the storm's over. Got a room? I've been riding all night. Want to get a little sleep before the stage gets in.
Expecting trouble?
I'm always expecting trouble. Is there a place around here where I can watch goings on?
I got it. My room. You see that knothole?
Yeah.
Well, all you got to do is pull the rug just to one side, and you can see putting every corner of this room.
Cracky, say, that's getting made to order. Call me when the stage gets in, will you, Hank?
I'll ring the night bell. There's two beds up there. Take which one you want.
Good night, Hank.
Good night.
Whiskers, what a night.
A room with a stove in it. I'm chilly now, and I've got to steep me a cup of hot tea.
Well, there's a coal oil stove in every room. Here's your key. Sign Mr. and Mrs. right there. I suppose you folks would like the bridal chamber?
How much?
Well, we always get $2 for the bridal chamber. You see, it's the best in the house. And please be as quiet as you can. The man next to you gets up at 5.
Young man, what is it?
I can't
can't find it.
You can't? Nope. Well, whatever have you lost?
I ain't lost nothing.
Well, what in the world is it that you can't find?
Well, see, it's a...
I was tipped off the pokey duck bandits hereabouts.
Well, you don't expect him out in a storm like this, do you?
You can expect him anywhere there's money.
Reckon your tip was right, Sheriff, but how'd they get the combination?
I don't know. What's them?
Well, they're the safe combination number.
Yeah, you watched it through the window when you opened it. No use trying to trail him tonight.
No, by morning he'd be miles away.
Just the same, I'm going to run him down if it takes me 10 years.
Don't move. Put up your gun. Everything's all right, old timer. You're just in time for beans. Sit down.
think you're pretty slick, don't you?
No, just careful. Well, you might have been the polka dot bandit or some other notorious outlaw.
Huh? How do you know I ain't?
Just by your looks. Come on, let's see.
Beans sure smell good.
Well, help yourself.
Slick on the draw, too, ain't you, son?
No, old-timer, just force of habit.
Well, don't get excited. See, I carry this for snakes. Oh, I ain't insinuating that you're a snake, but here's to me right now is a good time to open it. You ever drink?
Well, in this particular case, yes.
You mind if I roll up here for the night?
No, old-timer, I'd be right glad to know you better.
Yeah? Well, I ain't so sure. Anyway, here's mud in your eye.
And how?
See any sign of Mason and the gang?
Saw a cloud of dust down by Cotton Creek.
Maybe the outlaws.
Oh, I hardly think so. How could they know when Mason was coming through?
Well, how did they know before? I tell you, there's a skunk in this town, and we ought to run him down.
We ought to be hearing from Sacramento. That letter was sent 3 weeks ago.
Oh, rat. The government don't care nothing about us. We got to help ourselves.
You can't fight outlaws without ammunition. And we can get it.
They're just entering the pass. You boys know what to do. Remember, no harm has come to the girls.
Sign of outlaws yet, Betty. But I still insist you shouldn't have come.
Now, don't scold, Dad. It's been a wonderful trip.
Why'd you decide to drift along with me?
It's kind of lonesome trailing alone.
Yeah. If I ain't mistaken, you're going to have plenty of company.
Thank you.
Lord, please help us.
We got both of them. We'd better make sure. Sign of them. I reckon they're on the bottom.
Well, I pretty near got you, old timer.
Yeah. The feel of my head, they did get me. What happened?
Well, they shot you off your horse and you fell over the cliff.
Into the water, eh? You pulled me out. Son, I reckon I owe you my life. I ain't forgetting that.
Don't worry about that, Dad. We gotta get out of here. Think you can make it?
Well, I'll make it or bust a cinch.
Everything worked out just as you planned, only we bumped into a couple of strangers. We had a run and fight. They got Jake, but they're on the bottom of the river.
What about the girl? Are you sure she didn't recognize you?
Nah, we didn't get close enough for that.
She's probably in town by now. Come on.
After the outlaws. I ran to Dad and found him.
There, Miss Betty.
Miss Betty, you must let me take care of you. I want you to consider my ranch your home until we can make more definite plans for your future. I want you to know that I'll do everything possible to help you.
And you'll send someone for him?
I'm going myself, right away. Oh, Mrs. Williams, I want you to take care of Betty until I return.
Gonna bring him into town.
Yeah? Well, you can give us a hand then.
Sets in, we're trapped.
We're trapped now. We can only last a few days longer.
Let's all get out. I tell you, it's the only solution.
I think you're right. How can we get out when our money is all gone for food that we never got?
Men, I have a little money, not much, but I'll do this. In order that we can get out, I'll give you $100 each for your homestead. I'm taking a long chance of ever getting my money back, but I'll risk it.
Oh, it's my square, Melrose. Come on,
that's not right. Just a minute. Don't you think before you sell your homes for a few dollars that you should take at least one more chance at getting the provisions through?
Our men have families. There's been enough killing.
That's right. Why not let us take a crack at it?
If you can get us provisions, I'll pay you well.
Forget that. You give us an order and we'll have the provisions back here inside of 4 days.
Good. And come to my ranch this afternoon, and I'll give you an order for $1,000 supply.
That's it! Let's pack and get out.
See that pal of Melgrove's? You're going to be mighty interested in him right soon.
Who is he?
Keeping that for a surprise.
Huh? I'm keeping a surprise for you, too.
Come on.
Miss Mason the spare room.
Si, senor.
Remember, this is to be your home, Betty. It's going to be a great pleasure to have you with me. I thought you said those two men were at the bottom of the river.
I'd swear those were the two we shot down.
If it hadn't been for those two meddlers, the town would be moving out right now.
Well, anyway, you got the girl.
And remember this. She's private property. Hands off.
Yeah, you better tell the boys not to be talking around here. She might find out who you really are. Kent made another inspection of Homestead Valley. Swears it'll be the richest gold strike ever discovered. Runs right through the middle of all the ranches.
We'll soon be rid of those hombres. The town will move out. And we'll own the gold field.
Señor, la muchacha está escuchando.
Take her to the hideout. We'll keep her there till the town is deserted.
You don't dare.
I'm going over to Melgrove's and get that order.
Only one came over.
What's he doing in the bunkhouse?
I don't know. But now is your chance. Remember, no shooting.
Boys, tell me where Melgrove is.
Why, yeah, I think you'll find him right.
Come on, get in.
this all about? I asked these men here. My boys have orders to hold all strangers. They didn't understand. I'm very sorry.
Oh, that's all right, Melgrove. We were just playing.
Here's your order, and I wish you luck. When are you leaving?
Right now. We expect to be back before daylight. You see, the outlaws won't be expecting us that soon.
I hope you'll get through.
Well, it won't be our fault if we don't, eh, Jake?
You said it, son.
Won't be expecting them, eh? They'll find out. It's the things we least expect that usually happen.
I thought we was going to Sandy.
We're not going to be that foolish, old-timer. They'd be waiting for us at the pass.
And you think Melgrove and Dandy are with the outlaws?
There's no doubt about it.
Well, what's to be done?
That all depends on what happens between now and tomorrow morning. I wonder what happened to Miss Mason.
Tail goes to the hide.
Well, hi,
boss.
Hi.
We'll leave at dawn. They'll be coming through early. Where's the girl?
In the strong room. She won't eat.
She'll get over that. I'll have a talk with her tomorrow.
Miss Mason. Betty.
Oh, I'm so glad you found me.
Tell me briefly what's happened.
They caught me overhearing their plans and brought me here. Melgrove is the leader. He's trying to force the people out so he can get their land.
But why?
Well, you see, under their topsoil is a rich gold deposit, and it runs right through all the ranches. Kent is in with them.
Well, they'll be leaving early. I'll be back shortly after dawn to get you. Now try and get some sleep. Good night.
Wake up, old-timer.
Huh? What's the matter?
Lean out them ears. I got a world of news for you.
Where you been?
I followed Melgrove to the hideout.
Hey, that sounds interesting. Go on.
Well, they're holding Miss Mason prisoner. And I got to talk to her, and she gave me the lowdown on the whole deal. Now, listen to this.
back by noon. I want you to guard this place, boys. Keep your eye on the girl. If anybody comes, shoot.
Okay, boss.
Try and find the wagon. I'll go get the girl.
I've located the wagon and the horses.
Good. Give me a lift here. We're taking this hombre with us.
I'll take him.
All right. Miss Mason.
Yes.
Hurry and get ready. They've gone. They're headed for the hideout. Keep back. I'm going to break this in. Are you ready? I'll meet you at the tunnel.
All right.
Hey, son, there's enough grub in there to last a year. Come on.
Now, just where do you think you're going?
work, son, but we gotta hurry. They're coming back.
Take that roan horse behind those trees and race for town.
Hey, son, here's a box of dynamite. Might come in handy.
Girl, Daddy.
Here they come, old-timer. Don't miss your mark. Means the lives of everyone in town.
Under your topsoil is the richest gold field ever discovered.
Hooray! Hooray! Boys, here comes the wagon!
Well, men, your troubles are all over. The outlaws are buried in the past.
Well, you see, fellas, we're like this.
I don't know how I can ever repay you.
Oh, don't worry about that. It's all in my line of duty as a government marshal. But I am leaving for Sacramento today, and, well, you don't know it, but you're going with me.
Andy's dead. Must have got slugged from one of his own men.
Sheriff, congratulate me. May I present the future Mrs. John Carruthers?
Hey, wait a minute, young man. You can't do this. You see, I know who you are.
So does Miss Mason.
You mean to say you're willing to... Now, see here, young fella. I ain't forgetting you saved my life or what you done for this town. But I got my duty to perform. Can't you see I got to take you in? Don't you realize I know you're the pokey duck?
Why, Sheriff, you must have seen me through the knot hole.
You're right, by cracky, I did.
But you saw the wrong man. The polka dot bandit left just ahead of me. He left this rowel sticking in the floor. You must have seen me just as I picked that up. And that rowel belongs to Dante.
Well, what do you make of this?
Well, I found those in Dante's room yesterday. Dante's the polka dot bandit. There's a $5,000 reward for him, Sheriff. I guess it's up to you to collect it.
Well, if Daddy's a pokey dot, who in blazes are you?
Why, he's a United States Marshal. He's your man from Sacramento.